do Angelina Jolie and George Clooney have in common? Symmetry. According to some researchers, symmetry is super sexy. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Pair bonding is a trademark of the human animal. We flirt, we fall in love, we marry, but what is it that attracts us to someone else? Is it their eyes, their lips, their smell? Well, researchers keep looking for answers. While some say it's all in the scent, that humans respond largely to pheromones or chemicals released to signal things like fertility. We've covered that in an earlier episode. Check out the link to that video here, or if you're on mobile, there's a link in the description down below. But what about looks? Well, according to Tina Fey in her book Bossy Pants, a modern attractive woman has to have so many different attractive body parts, like a cut and paste doll out of a magazine. But do all those individual pieces add up to a sexy whole? Maybe not so. Recent research from Queen's University says humans' attractiveness is based on consistency of the whole rather than attractive individual parts. Basically, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. The researchers said that older studies tend to focus on individual features like face shape or lip color, things like that. So they wanted to try something a little different. In their study, they focused on movement and body shape. So that's like how sexy someone sashayed as they walk. The researchers showed participants dots based on someone's movement and shape and were asked to rate their attractiveness. Then the researchers blended those movements to create a kind of hybrid person. The strange thing was that participants found the hybrids to be less sexy. The researchers think that internal consistency, whether the movement and the shape match each other or not, matters a whole lot, and that we can detect if anything seems, well, off. They say our visual system is a sensitive lie detector that perceives even the slightest inconsistencies and responds negatively to them. So what is sexy? Well, it depends really on who you ask and even what their culture is. But there is one constant trait that most cultures find sexy. Most studies repeatedly show that people find symmetry attractive. Over 20 years ago, researchers from the University of Albuquerque suspected that symmetry had a lot to do with sex appeal. They asked students to rank how attractive faces were and found that those faces with higher symmetry were at the top of the list. So why is symmetry sexy? Well, the idea is that symmetry somehow signals genetic fitness, or how likely you are to toss your genes into the future, or maybe it's a sign of health, and they might be onto something. The same researchers continued studying symmetry and sex appeal, and a more recent study in the journal Animal Behavior found a link between symmetry and oxidative stress. Oxidative stress can be caused by free radicals, molecules produced as cells use oxygen. Sometimes these molecules can cause cell damage. If a person is exposed to oxidative stress in the womb, it might mean a less symmetrical face. And the researchers found results which suggested just that. They found that men with low levels of oxidative stress were more symmetrical and ranked as highly attractive by women. Yet symmetry might mean more than just good genes. One study published in the journal Psychonomic Bulletin and Review found that those with symmetrical faces tended to be more extroverted and friendly, character traits that a lot of us like in our potential mate. As for other physical traits like big lips, round hips, or jaw size, well, those really depend on culture. Women in wealthier nations prefer weaker jaws and less masculine-looking men, for example. While these kinds of traits seem to be rated as sexy, there's some debate as to whether that's the result of our culture or our biology. So what do you think is sexy? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.